scare me like that.
You don't want to play Queen's Blood, do you? I was hoping that... Oh, what am I thinking? You look like you'd murder me. Oh, God, this is too much. I think I'm gonna throw up. Don't give me that look. It's perfectly healthy for adults to cry too, you know. People call me Crybaby Ned. Because the more tears I shed, the better I get at Queen's Blood. Please play around with me.
I lost, but I feel a lot better after having a good cry. There's nothing like a game of Queen's Blood to relieve some stress.
Speaking of, you look like you've got a lot weighing you down too. It's written all over your face. Trust me, crying does wonders. You really ought to try it.
Told me you can't get
Oh, looky here. I'd say we got ourselves a contender. So how about it, pretty boy? You want to throw down? But first, let me introduce you to Nene, Master Ventriloquist. Now, she ain't much of a talker, but give her a deck of cards, and she'll wipe the floor with you so fast, it'll make your head spin. Ready to get your ass handed to you? Well, are ya? this guy packs one hell of a punch. But hey, you can't win them all. Besides, what really matters is you were brave enough to take on a bona fide card shark like Pretty Boy here. Sometimes you gotta take the L if you're serious about upping your game. Listen, kid, you got what it takes to be a champ. I bet my bottom gill on it. Now why don't you show Blondie your appreciation for being such a good sport?
Thank you for playing cards with me, mister.
His wall, keeping us safe and secure. I could gaze at it all day. Excuse me. That was my barricade you just destroyed. Oh, come to admire the Bailey? It is something. Or maybe you're here to get your ass handed to you in a QB match. I'm Zahira. A pleasure. Just like Calm's wall, I yield to no one, refusing to give a single inch to my opponents. Don't presume you'll emerge unscathed if you decide to go up against me. Because you will wind up with more than just a few bruises.
How could someone break through my perfect defense? Who are you?
Deep down, I always knew. I knew I couldn't stay holed up in here forever. Walls can keep people safe, but even the sturdiest ones eventually crumble. Right. Starting today, you will be my new wall, as it were. And I am going to enjoy watching you crumble.
Isabel, by the way. Was looking for a challenge, but failed miserably. Since this place was a total bust, I figured I ought to try my luck elsewhere.
Although, maybe you can put up a decent fight. What do you say?
One round of QB before I set sail?
Took the wind right out of my sails. And here I was thinking my ship was unsinkable. Happy to be proven wrong, though. Especially by a real pro. Glad we could get that match in before I moved on. With all that pent-up frustration, I wouldn't have been able to think or sail straight. Thanks for clearing my head. I'm gonna stick around a bit longer. Just enough to swab the deck once more.
Would you look at that? I finally hooked a catch, and a good one, too. Bet you thought you could blow me out of the water just because I'm getting on in years, hmm? Well, think again. I'm this town's ace angler, Zogan, and I've caught much bigger QB fish than you, Sonny, I tell you that much. You young'uns can thrash all you like, but you'll never beat my years of experience. Goodness me, this makes you the one that got away. Serves me right for looking down on you just because you're young. Queen's blood is a lot like fishing, you know? Gotta be patient, wait for the right moment, then bail 'em in. Time it wrong, and you'll be watching your victory swim away. Just look what happened to me. Guess I had a bigger catch on my hands than I thought. I should have been more careful.
I'm a rambling, gambling fella. You with an agency? Here to sign me? No, wait. You came out here just to see the famous Queensblood rocker. All right, twist my arm, why don't you? I'll give you the show of a lifetime.
I'm good.
Oof! Savage! So you're not a talent scout or a fan. Why didn't you say something? The name's Neil, and I'm gonna be the world's greatest QB playing guitarist. What do you say? Wanna play against a future celebrity?
Thank you.
God damn, dude! You legit wiped the floor with me! Then again, I can count on one hand the times I've won! I might actually not be cut out for this.
Hear that?
An upbeat melody's coming to me, clear as day. That's it. I could feel my spirits rising. I knew I was a musical genius. That loss was just what I needed to get my groove back. Oh, I can tell this one's gonna be good. One of these days, I'll make it to the big time. Give my folks the life they deserve. Until then, there's nothing for it but to keep strumming guitar and playing cards.
I want to tell you how we can...
Hello.
My name's Michaela, and I'm a proud member of the CAS's Queen's Blood Promotion Committee. Our goal is to spread awareness about the game's diplomatic potential. We believe it's our best shot at getting Shinra to agree to negotiations with us. What do you say? Want to play and help me drum up interest?
Thank you.
was great! See what I'm talking about? That connection you feel when you're playing someone! You, my friend, are now officially a member of the Queen's Blood Promotion Committee. People laugh, but I really think this game has the power to bring folks together in a way few things can. Because the key to world peace isn't violence. It's joy. Plain and simple joy. Comrade, I hereby ask you to go forth and play Queen's Blood. Spread the joy of gaming. I'm counting on you.
Who among you is a worthy woman? Finally. Someone who's worth a damn. I'm Cameron, Queen's Blood champion. And I roam the world in search of proper sport. I've scaled mountains, braved wastelands. As I communed with nature, I received a vision. The true spirit of this game we both play. And now I shall reveal it to you. Are you prepared? Then come.
wrong? I don't understand. It was just supposed to be a game. There it is again. That voice. Could it be? Has returned? No, that's impossible. It's just a silly card game. I have to tell them. They all need to know the terrible truth about Queen's blood.
You okay? Were you granted a transcendent vision, as I too was? You look as though you've just seen a ghost. Saying that, I'm reminded of the story of Ladrell Balmon, the creator of Queen's Blood. After he started selling cards, he spoke of hearing a strange voice. He then withdrew from the public eye and became a recluse. No one saw him again until his death. There's no shortage of people who've had their lives turned upside down by the cards. Just goes to show what a deep and captivating game it is. This match of ours stands as proof of that truth as well, I believe. Thank you for this experience, my friend.
So stupid. I was better than this. I had a passion.
Special delivery, coming in!
Hey there, mister. Are you looking for someone to play Queen's Blood with? We'd be more than happy to go a round or two with you.
I'm Devin, the younger brother.
And I'm Darren, the older one.
And together, we're the Double D Duo, a team of twins who love Queen's Blood.
You'll face my little brother here first. If you win, then I'll take you on. Two for the price of one. Sweet deal, right?
Speaking of prices, if you lose against either of us, you gotta fork over 3 gil.
Not bad. But next, you gotta beat me. Don't worry, Devin. I promise I'll avenge you. I can't believe we lost.
You're better at this than I thought.
Hold up. Does this mean we don't get our free kill?
No, he totally still owes us. I'm pretty sure the deal was if we lost, we got three gil. Isn't that right? I'm just kidding. You may have beaten us this time, but we'll get that three gil from you yet. So if you're ever in the mood, come back and play.
A bit worked up is all. Wait, do you play Queen's Blood? Rolf gets really excited whenever he senses a skilled player nearby. You may find this hard to believe, but he's the world's only canine competitor, and he's pretty good too. Heh, he's saying he wants to go around with you. Well, you game?
Thank you.
loser. But you gotta admit, he's pretty good, right? Amazing, even. Rolf is actually scheduled to make his television debut. They're doing a special on animals who can play Queen's Blood. And once we get famous, we can finally kiss this town goodbye. We got this. Right, Rolf?
Then spit it out. Just know that I'm such a badass that even Beck and his bitches couldn't handle me. Kick me out of their stupid little gang. That's right. You're standing face to face with the legendary Biff. You shaking in your boots yet? Oh. Tough guy, huh? Respect. But it seems to me like we got no choice but to settle this with a game of Queen's Blood. And if I whoop your ass, you gotta give me 7 whole gil! Secret. Truth is, I bailed from the bandit life because I just couldn't hack it. So I figured I'd turn over a new leaf and become a Queen's Blood player instead, but turns out I'm no good at that neither. You gotta tell me, what's the trick, man? How do I get your kind of skills? What, don't like handing out free advice or something? Only a real cheapskate would charge for that shit, asshole. Well, better hang on to that gill of yours, cause next time we meet, I'ma take 7 off you for sure.
you? I'm in the middle of a performance. Are you here to play Queen's Blood? That's going to be tricky. I'm a living statue, you see. I'm not supposed to move under any circumstances. Well, I guess I could move my arms at least. You're going to regret making me come to life. Completely demolished. Well played, good sir. But my performance isn't as bad. Would you agree? Someday, I hope to join the Gold Saucer's grand stable of performers. That's why I'm trying to hone my skills by purposely putting myself in the harshest of environments. But my winning streak was starting to draw negative attention, so maybe losing was for the best. I'll be here for a while yet. If you would like to play another game, just let me know.
Congratulations, Cloud. You have attained the rank of Blood Knight, and I have obtained intel on a new opponent for you. There is a somewhat mysterious player by the name of Novalon in North Corel. Having proven yourself as a knight, I believe you can defeat this formidable foe.
Anyone beat these cheats for us?
Wanna know my secret to victory?
itself. Oh, where have you been, handsome? I take it you're here to join me for a drink? Well, aren't you the sweetest little thing? Ugh. You big party pooper. Fine, be that way. Guess we'll play Queen's Blood instead. Oh no, don't even try to wiggle out of it. Because I'm Mary, darling dear. And when I've knocked a few back, nobody slips through my fingers. So, either you take a drink, or we play a game. Your choice. Well, shit. You got me good, hot stuff. Should've had more to drink. I have a confession to make. You see, my dear, even though it's my surefire ticket to victory, I've kind of been cutting back on the booze. Do you want to know why? A while back, I drank way too much, blacked out in the middle of a match, and had an awful nightmare. I dreamed this creepy stranger was trying to chat me up, which is why this match totally doesn't count. I am still off my game. Next time, you better bet I'm gonna be sauced to the max. So watch out, boyo.
I I don't hang out with the nicest folks, but throw me a bone here. What's up? What do you want? Oh, shit! I did it again! I'm sorry, old habit. No harm, man. Please don't go. I'm begging you. I only want to play a game of Queen's Blood. I promise, that's all. I have a hard time talking to people, and, well, I know I'm not the friendliest looking guy, so I can't convince anyone to go around. Anyway, the name's Jack. You, want to play with me? Pretty please? That was even more fun than I'd imagined! I've been missing out. Prison ain't a great place to let your guard down, you know? So I got into the habit of acting tough and yelling at anyone who looked at me funny. Kept me safe, but it also made good, decent people like you avoid me altogether. Even though I just wanted to play cards. I got so frustrated that no one would give me the time of day that I started to resent the judgy bastards. But I've got to change myself first if I want people to talk to me. Because you had the courage to approach me when no one else did. I know that now. So I'm going to do it like you and ask people to play instead of waiting for them to come to me.
I am hit it.
I am hit
it. Excuse me. We're shooting here.
Wait. Do you play Queen's Blood? You kind of look like you do.
Oh my gosh, this is perfect.
Ariana, an up-and-coming model. We're actually getting pics for a feature right now. And I was really hoping to nab one of me playing Queen's Blood. You literally couldn't have come at a better time. What do you say? Help a girl out?
That knitted brow, glistening perspiration, perfection! I've never seen you look more beautiful!
And you, Mr. Card Sharp, talk about a hunky diamond in the rough.
Have you ever thought about becoming a model?
Mala, you're a genius! We could team up, be a card-slinging, catwalk-strutting duo! You and me, taking over the world! What do you say?
No.
Harsh.
We'll be kicking it here for a bit if you change your mind. After all, a model's work is never done.
Oh
the shore.
What are you looking at? You want a piece of me or something? Easy now. I didn't mean it like that.
No need to be so on edge.
Name's Mihir, though some call me the Child of the Sun. I'm training to be a boxer. I've not been feeling it lately, so I'm trying other ways to motivate myself. Like Queen's Blood. I don't suppose you're up for a game. What a knockout! You got me. Not only was your defense on point, but your offense was swift and brutal. I've never played such an intense game. It was hotter than the sun! Enough to light a fire in my soul, even. I think I'm finally out of my funk. And now, I can get back to boxing. Thank you.
Against my little angels here. Name's Dokacha. I believe in my cards and they believe in me. We're like a big happy family. You wanna know how I got them to love me? With praise. You're so cute, you're so cool. You gotta show them every day how much you care. But I also wanna tell them how strong and hardworking they are too, you know? Which is why I've been looking high and low for someone I can play against.
four babies! As much as I hate to admit it, it seems you have a much stronger bond with your cards than I do. Just what do you say to them to get them to love you so much? Huh? So you let your actions speak louder than your words? I see. By the way, on a completely different subject, have you ever heard of the card, the Shadow Blood Queen? Apparently there's only one. I tell you, if that's true, I hope I get the chance to see it in person someday. I bet it's the most beautiful card anyone's ever laid eyes on.
So, you have begun to fulfill your potential. Long have I awaited this day. At ease, young soldier. I took your measure the moment you set foot in this town. Hard not to, given your presence. I am Navalon of the Thousand Eyes. Years of meditation have granted me sight beyond sight. It is this clarity which shows me all. Even that which some wish to keep hidden. You exude a powerful, yet troubled aura. Indeed, it makes you the perfect opponent. Come, and don't you dare hold anything back.
Ladrell Balmont, and I am the creator of the game Queen's Blood. Which means that this nightmare is of my own making. I didn't know. How could I? You hear her too. commanding me. She's made me her prisoner. Her cursed guard, my shackle. The end is nigh. Or perhaps this is only the beginning. The Shadow Blood Queen is...
Ah, let me guess. You have dreamt the dream of Ladrell Balmon too.
What do you know about it?
Only rumors and hearsay that players of particular skill have experienced strange visions of late. Visions in which one is visited by the ghost of the game's creator, who speaks of portentous events. To add another wrinkle, some of the world's very best have recently met with unnaturally violent deaths. People are calling this the Curse of Ladrell. Not even my third eye can discern the true cause, though it is clearly something sinister. If you wish to continue on the path of the cards, then remain vigilant, or it may lead to your undoing.
We'll be right back.
What? Did I open the door? I should have heeded the stories. The warnings. It is an
questions for us.
What's this smell? It's awful. Mr. Balmon, are you home?
Oh my god, I can't believe it. Mr. Balmon is dead. How long has he been in here? It must have been ages. His body is...
The results of the autopsy reveals the cause of death to be starvation. The state in which he was found suggests that he had been playing Queen's Blood without stopping to eat, drink, or sleep.
I found numerous cards scattered on the floor around him, and... Hold on. What's this? That card... It looks like... The Shadow.
The recording breaks up after that. As it so happens, Mr. Belmont was in possession of the world's one and only Shadow Blood Queen card. However, the card was not found in his home, leading to theories that the reporter who discovered the body stole it. The reporter in question subsequently went missing and... Unexpected shutdown occurred. System rebooting. Do not shut off power. What was I doing? Memory restored. I had just registered a loss against you in a game of Queen's Blood.
Yeah.
Version update required to secure path to world domination. Thank you very much for playing with me.
Is that SSL? Used to be a soldier. Lots of hand signals. That's how Shinra Sign Language came to be a thing. I know the basics. Queen's Blood, huh?
Thank you.
your fight, though. Hang on. Are you ex-military, too? Solid idea. Good luck with that.
Home, who you are? Ha ha ha! Could this shark be more of a guppy? Well, I spy a row of razor sharp teeth in this little fishy's maw. You might be the QB killer we've been waiting for, but there's only one way to find out. That's right, our audience doesn't want to hear commentary, they want to see blood! To up the ante, our challenger's opponent will be none other than your host with the most, me, Bernard! Talk about carnage, am I right? I'm lucky I got out of that match with my limbs intact. Today's shark is a ferocious man-eating menace. He made a serious splash with some ruthless moves. Players the world over have got to be shaken in their boots. Something tells me this beast is about to upset the QB food chain. Better start swimming. Congratulations to you, sir, for an incredible match. Though we found the canyon's resident shark, the fun never ends on this show. Stay tuned, because we've got more coming your way.
More than a passing interest in Queen's blood, it has bewitched you. Be at ease. It is only natural to hear its call. Queen's blood is of the planet and for the planet. It, like all things, is part of the great cycle that connects us. Indeed, each and every card holds within it a greater purpose, one that belies their form. Come, join me in a match that you too may glimpse the truth of our great mother. Turn I did not expect, which confirms my fears. A strange, Wicked Paul hangs over the life stream, and a similar dark energy has corrupted Queen's blood. Be careful. The game's pleasures belie the thorns beneath that will bleed you slowly and surely. Many devotees have succumbed to the darkness of which I spoke. Too many. Remember, the cards are a link between us and the planet. If you are in trouble, reach out. She shall answer. Oh, Great Mother, hear my prayer. Watch over your son.
What is this? Cloud, fancy seeing you again. What are you doing here? No, don't tell me. Are you here for a match? I'm game, I guess. Oh, come on. You doing this or what?
Let me tell you a story. Once, there lived a queen of peerless his beauty and compassion. She loved her people. And they, in turn, loved her. But one day, a change came over the Queen. In the blink of an eye, her love turned to hate, her compassion to cruelty. Fair and beauteous though she remained, her heart became black as pitch. Conquest was now her cause, her subjects mere fodder to feed her boundless ambition. And so her kingdom grew as her people perished. Until, that is, a ray of hope appeared. A sorceress who would be their salvation. The Emerald Witch, they called her. And with her arcane powers, she led the people in rebellion, captured the Queen, and put her to death. Yet from the Emerald's monsters filled blood as dark as shadow. And from this wicked Ichor, the myriad fiends of the world were born. And that is the story of the Shadow Blood Queen. Some call it a parable, a myth, a fairy tale, and I wish it were. But she is as real as you and I. And she is coming. Her resurrection is nigh. You know what must be done. She cannot be allowed to return. She must not reclaim her throne. I pray you will succeed where I so miserably failed. You are our last hope, Cloud. I await you at the Haunted Hotel. You must hurry.
Don't mind me. Not been feeling so hot. Hey, Cloud. Do you know anything about the Shadow Blood Queen card? It's the most powerful card in the world. One of a kind. Though, it seems there's a special card that can supposedly counter it. The Emerald Witch.
Sorry. Just forget I said anything.
Tired is all. Too many competitions lately.
Ah, you there! Don't ask how I can tell, but you're into Queen's Blood, aren't you? Isn't that great, Oscar? I've found someone you can play against. Let me introduce you. This is Oscar the Swift. He's a watch chocobo. A huge Queen's Blood fan, too. He gets cranky if he can't play at least one game a day. So, how about it? Mind going around with him? Whoa. This is the first time I've ever seen Oscar lose. Didn't expect that. Seems like he's a little bitter. Anyway, thanks so much for indulging him. He can make it a lot harder for us to do our jobs when he's in a mood. Really, believe it or not, he's gonna make his television debut soon. He'll be up against a dog that plays Queen's Blood, and we have to make sure he wins to help drive up tourism here. He'll pull it off.
Come now, that's enough. Can't you see you're scaring the poor man? Sorry for all that. It doesn't take much for them to get worked up. I'm Ji-jun, a farmer. I should be hard at work, but my back's forcing me to take a break for a short while. Oh, do you play Queen's Blood, by chance? A game would help to pass the time. Sitting around soaking up the sun is all well and good, but at this rate, it's liable to put me to sleep.
you something. Why, you were running circles around me like one of those professional racing chocobos. So is that how all you young folk play these days? Oh, Queen's Blood sure has changed. Us old timers can't keep up anymore. But you know, that's exactly the way it should be. You're better off harnessing that energy. Oh, you've still got enough to live life to the fullest. You can sit and relax to your heart's content when you get older, and your back starts giving you no say in the matter. That's why you should spend your youth getting up to all kinds of mischief. If you ever tire yourself out, though, I'll be here with my cards. A little downtime can do a body good.
Player, do you? It's no use denying it. You're slacking off because you want to play Queen's Blood. Because you're just like me. I won't tell if you won't. Comrade, the name's Turner, the top truant. I say, screw working. I'm all about playing hooky. You'd be hard-pressed to find anyone who's better at it than me. I don't give a damn about demotions. Prepare yourself! That was impressive. I didn't think you'd beat me so easily. when I entered contests on the clock, I always won. Wait, could you be more of a slacker than me? But I devote all my time outside of roll calls specifically to playing Queen's Blood. Oh, I see. You're unemployed. Living the dream. No, that's none of my business. You're a bigger fish. That's all. It was an honor to have played with you. I hope I'll have another chance someday.
Queen's Blood with you, if that's what you want, okay? I'm so sorry. This is Dale. He loves playing Queen's Blood more than anything else in the world. Actually, I don't suppose you would mind playing a match or two with him. Just real quick, I'm not the best player. So I think he's been looking for someone who'll give him more of a challenge. I don't think I've ever seen him this happy. It must have been a great match.
Oh, Shadow Blood. Queen. Witch.
That's enough, Dale. He has other things to do, I'm sure. Thank you so much for taking the time to play with him.
Thank you.
doubt that I ever truly doubted your potential. I was right to leave you that letter.
Letter? What letter?
You remember, don't you? The inn at Calm? I hung it on your door, though I signed it in the proprietor's name.
So that was you?
Forgive my subterfuge, but I was in dire need of a skilled player. And you certainly did not disappoint. You were even able to best me. Which, while impressive, won't be enough. Not if you intend to hold the Shadowblood Queen's card in your deck. That foul thing is the source of this nightmare. The very embodiment of the villain herself. Through the card, she feeds on the wielder's life force, claiming their strength, that she may one day be reborn. Countless players have succumbed to this vile curse. And now one more death is all she requires to return. Cloud, find the sorceress. She who rallied the people. She who deposed the queen, the Emerald Witch. Her card sleeps in Nibelheim with a monster of chaos. You must hurry before it is too late.
Congratulations, Cloud. You have attained the rank of Blood Sovereign. This is it. Only one opponent remains. The Monster of Chaos. I know nothing of their skills, but I have faith that yours are superior. Vanquish this fiend and the witch's card will be yours.
Need something. Of course. Should have known I wasn't the only one seeing ghosts. Shame, though. Some stories are better forgotten, including the Queen's.
Know about the Witch's card? I heard you might have it.
The Emerald Witch? As luck would have it, the card does happen to be in my possession. But it could be yours, should you prove yourself worthy. It seems a transfer of ownership was in the cards after all. Be warned. That which appears a mere pastime is shrouded in darkness. I suggest you proceed with caution, lest it consume you too. This situation is graver than I feared. Here, she'll guide you to the Queen. The rest is in your hands.
I see you successfully obtained the Emerald Witch. I noticed the card was radiating energy, which I took the liberty of analyzing. It revealed the location of the Queen. Evidently, she resides within some ruins in the Gungaga region. The climax of this saga is nigh, and only you, the Blood Executioner, can bring it to a close. Best of luck.
Cloud, it's you. Didn't think you'd come. You mind? We'd prefer to have this conversation in private. Here it is. The source of everything. All I ever wanted was to be worth something. Queen's blood gave me that. Got people to respect me, fear me, until I started fearing for myself, for what I might become. Because I can't keep winning forever, and once I start losing, I'll be worthless. Worse, a nobody. When I found her, I knew that I would never lose again. That I'd been chosen for something greater. That I was blessed. But this isn't that at all. It's been speaking to me. Telling me to give myself to her power. To dominate. I've tried not to for so long, but I can't.
Regina?
Yes. I remember well this land, for it was once mine. Until that witch rallied the unwashed and put me to the sword. Well, little puppet, what do you say? A match against your queen. For you, human, have a blood debt to pay in full.
Thank you. Impossible. What foul sorcery. Accursed witch. Even in death, you would thwart me.
You good?
What about...
She's gone.
Oh, she is she? Be still, little puppet. You belong to me now.
Cloud! Use the card!
Don't you dare!
Game over!
Thank you, Cloud. For stopping her. For stopping me. Guess I really let all that genius crap go to my head, huh? After a while, losing became my worst nightmare. I'd do anything to win. And look where it got me.
You are not to blame for this. Evil like that preys on our deepest, darkest fears and worms its way into our hearts. You ever break free.
You're the best because you worked your ass off, not because you're a genius. Got it?
Got it.
Well, on that note, I'd better get back to it. After all, there can only be one card queen. So next time you want to throw down, you best come prepared.
Right.
Later!
All's well that ends well, I suppose.
Thanks to you.
Couldn't have you dying on me just yet.